have your attention, please. It's time for the final countdown. The show starts in 10, 9.
Time. Hello, everybody. It's John Wild in full Back to the Future mode here. Baby, we're going down the John Wild rabbit hole, ladies and gentlemen. So, yeah, we had Back to the Future Day just a couple of days ago. How did you spend your day? I went back to when I was a teenager to visit my ex-girlfriends. Yeah, baby, that's what I did. And now, inexplicably, there's a whole bunch of 30-year-olds that just popped out of nowhere that look like me. All right, welcome to the John Wild Show. And I tell you, right now I'm getting. By the way, I'm John Wild, and my producer today is Dina, as always. And I'm getting these signs from her not to look directly at the screen. She's got this screen set up that she basically sends me messages during the show of what to say, what not to say. You know, what's queued up, what's not queued up, what's happening, and all those other kind of stuff. And if I look right up, that I can see it looking like this. I can see it. If I look right up to it, I look like some kind of robot of some sci-fi thing from the 1970s. I read you. So I got to make sure we're wearing my Back to the Future glasses that I keep my head down. So anyway, so what are we going to be talking about on today's show? You know, my show is not scripted. I have some subjects that I'm going to talk about, but it's just us hanging out and having some coffee or some booze and relaxing and just talking and just sharing and me telling you what's right and wrong in the world. That's basically what it is. Today I'm enjoying a dark Cuban roast coffee, and believe me, I like dark Cuban. Anyway, so take a drink. Yeah, any dark Cubans out there, the name's John Wild. I have plenty of experience with Cubans, so there you go. Anyway, so we're going to be talking about a lot of things today. Some of the subjects that we're going to be talking about is the new Bambi live-action movie that's going to get ready to come out here real soon, and how Disney is changing up this live-action Bambi film and making some changes that I think are ridiculously stupid. And it's all because we are a butthurt society these days, and everything's got to be so nice and flowers. Well, folks, reality is not nice and flowers, and reality sometimes sucks. Things in your life suck, okay? And if we start teaching our children at a young age that sometimes life is just not fair, then they're going to have a better time at it when they get older, okay? I was taught from a very young age that life is not fair. Life is incredibly unfair. And to deal with it and stop being so damn butthurt about everything in the world, and then, you know, you're going to be okay. That's basically it. Excuse me? Anyway. Okay, sometimes I push the buttons, sometimes she pushes the buttons. I don't know why she... Yeah, I think you're trying to play a joke on me. We're also going to be talking about... some questions that people ask on social media that Dino has gathered together for me to answer. We have some mail that we're going to go through, and also we're going to do a taste testing. I have never had this before, and basically it's a new Coca-Cola. Can you see it? Yeah. So we're going to try this new Coca-Cola flavor and see what it's like. I think it's been out for a while, but I haven't tried it. So we're going to give that a shot and see what it's like. We're going to talk about Christmas coming up. We got a lot of things to talk. We're going to be talking about Pulse Nightclub and some breaking news about Pulse Nightclub. Now, I don't know if we have people that listen all over the world that watch my show. By the way, you can watch my show, Dino. Correct me if I'm wrong here, but she uploads it on YouTube, Facebook, the Facebook page, TikTok, coming soon X or Twitter or whatever the hell you want to call it this week. Yeah, and then there's going to be a Patreon, I think, or something like that, and then the website. So you'll be able to really catch the show anywhere that you look. And so, yeah, please do so. And in the social medias, there's a lot of comments because we don't do this live. We're going to be answering some of those questions on the comments, and we're going to have a lot of fun. The main topic of today, what I'm going to talk about, is the entertainment business. I've been in a conversation with a few people lately. And I get a lot of questions about the entertainment business because they know that I'm real and I don't lie and I don't manufacture things and I bust myths and I tell them the truth about a lot of things. And I get a lot of questions about the entertainment business. Sorry, I'm going to try to stop looking up at the screen so much, guys. Sorry about that. But I'm going to tell you some of the truths. And where I'm going to focus in on is a lot of these young talents out there that are trying to make it the music business, but as actors and models, and what the reality is, okay? And we're going to be talking about that. And, of course, before I even talk about that, I will tell you what my qualifications are to be able to teach you the right from wrong. But no matter what you do when you hear what I have to say, you can believe me or not, but it's reality. It's the way it is. So you can continue on your fantasy world, or you can listen to somebody who knows what the hell they're talking about. And we'll talk about that later on, and we're going to have a good time. But one thing I want to let everyone know. Now, I know we're in the midst of Halloween. It's the spooky time of the year. We're all getting ready to go out and gather some candy and have a good time. In fact, I have somewhere. Where is it at? You know? Oh, yeah. It's very rare that I have. If anybody wants to mail me something, go ahead and make a comment that you would like to mail something, and Dino will let you know where to mail it to. But I actually got a John Wilde show, what appears to be a Halloween card, I'm assuming, with the color of this. So we're going to open this up now and see what it is. She's torn it, but she hasn't opened it, so I'm going to open it up. I can hardly read it because I got my sunglasses on. Who misses you? Oh, who misses me? Look at that. Who misses you? Who are you? So let's open it up and find out who misses. Oh, my gosh. Hi there. Look at that. Come on, please, really? Hi there, John. Thank you for the entertainment. Thank you for the laughs. You know that you're always loved, and I love you dearly. You're a fan, and I'm going to remain anonymous here. I'm not going to say who it is. And, oh, P.S., here's $5 donation to your show. Please keep it going. I will try to send more. You don't have to do that, but thank you very much. You know, there is a way to donate to the show, but I haven't put that out there. This is only the first real show next to the very first experimental show. So how do I do my show? I just sit here and talk. I do what I do best. I sit here and listen to myself talk, and hopefully that you guys will tune in and listen to me. I try to come up with some interesting subjects, we're going to have guests. We're going to have all kinds of things. It's going to be a lot of fun. There's some music involved, and there's some jokes involved. There's going to be some games and prizes, too, that people can win by listening. And right now, I don't have any real sponsors or anything for the show, but as soon as they start popping up, I really want people. Yeah, I love donations. Thank you. That $5 was great. I've received some others. But going to our sponsors, And when you start to see them pop up, that is probably the greatest thing that you can do for me, is support sponsors as they pop up here and there. But as I said, we're in the middle of the scare holiday, and it's Halloween. I got Halloween in the back, and we're having a good old time. And now I'm thinking about Christmas is around the corner, and of course, Thanksgiving, one of my favorite days of the year. I love to eat a lot of food, and I love Thanksgiving, and I'm going to try to remember not to look up so much and blind you by the light. in my eyes, the light. Hold on. I got to do this right. I don't even know if I'm hitting the right button because I can't see. My light down here has gone out. Well, that's definitely not the right button. Well, that's always the right button, but.
The light in your eyes seems to shine on the John Wyo. Let me hold you, babe, and sing you to sleep. Oh, yeah.
Just with you, that actually sounds kind of creepy. It's supposed to sound romantic, and it's actually sounding kind of weird. But anyway, so we're going to get into things here right away. We're going to jump into it. We're not going to take any. We're going to take a break now. No, later in a little bit. Yeah, we're going to be taking a break here in a little bit, and I want you to hang through the breaks. So we have some surprises during our breaks. First thing, we're going to talk about some breaking news coming out of Orlando, Florida. As I said, we are based in Orlando, Florida, but we are heard from all over the world. But this was worldwide news when it broke. Everyone knows what happened at the Pulse nightclub many years ago. Wow, how long has it been? It's been like 5 years or better, even more than that. When a gunman went into the Pulse nightclub and just started murdering everyone that he could. There are several people. I mean, there were dozens and dozens of people. I forget the exact number, 50, 60, 70 people who were killed in the nightclub and hundreds of others injured. The Orlando Police Department SWAT team made entry into the club through a wall and shot the assailant dead. And for the longest time, this memorial, which is on South Orange Avenue and I believe at Cayley Street, has been a memorial to all these people who lost their lives. And also it's a memorial to much more than that. It's a memorial to ending hate no matter what. Now you may disagree with someone's lifestyle, totally disagree with it to the point that it upsets you, but it's not right to hate anyone in this world. You don't hate somebody because they've got a certain belief, okay? You just have to understand that they don't hate you because of your beliefs. Why are you gonna hate them because of theirs, okay? And unless you have a really super problem with yourself that you haven't addressed yet, it shouldn't bother you if two men or two women want to be together. It shouldn't bother you at all. And if it bothers you that much, maybe you need to explore your own feelings and come up with some answers. But one thing is concerned about me is the city of Orlando has agreed to pay the Pulse owners $2 million for that property. And if you've lived in Orlando for any time, you should know that the city of Orlando and the fathers and the mayor and all that don't know what the hell they're doing. They've done a lot for Orlando, but they've also done a lot to destroy what true Orlando's about and things that make Orlando Orlando. One of the ideas that they are having is actually to demolish the property and build something on it. So I'm like, first, if they demolish this property and they build other retail establishments or apartments or whatever there, would you want a business on a land where dozens and dozens, 50 or 60 or 70 people were murdered in a heinous way? Would you want to be on that property? I sure wouldn't. No, not for me. And I would never go to a store that's on that property. I've been to the Pulse Memorial, and I'm telling you, the time I was there, it was a very uneasy feeling for me. It really felt like there was a lot of eyes on me that were not there, if you know what I mean. Also, this is a sacred ground. This is a memorial. It needs to stay a memorial. Now, if they want to tear the building down and build a really nice something like a reflecting pool, something similar that they did in New York, I understand that. But we got to keep this a memorial. We got to keep this sacred. And the city of Orlando doesn't know sacred from a hole in the ground. They would rather just develop everything, money-hungry, money-grubbing idiots. the way I describe the government here in Orlando. So what is your thoughts about that? Comment below, comment anywhere. What is your thoughts? My thoughts is leave Pulse alone. Turn it into a memorial if you have to. If the Pulse Foundation couldn't take care of the grounds, and I don't understand why, they got enough donations. Something tells me that there was something going on the inside, and it's just kind of funny. So $2 million. Okay. And I think we should probably spend another million, $2 million to make a really nice memorial for those who lost their lives in a terrorist attack in Orlando. Okay. That's exactly what it was. There's no difference except for the amount of loss of life in than any other terrorist attack that we've had on this soil. And the three that really kind of come to mind, well, there's four, is Pearl Harbor, 9/11, the Vegas shooting, and Pulse. Okay, these areas are sacred ground where people lose their lives. And I'm sorry, if something like that goes down, it's sacred ground. That's all there is to it. I got one question. I'm not too sure exactly who asked this. Dina wasn't able to remember, but I'm sure you're right. Somebody asked me about the entertainment business, if I know people who worship the deity Moloch. Moloch? M-O-C-A-C-O-C-H. This is that two-headed bull demon that, I guess, sacrifices people and children into fires and all this. And be honest with you, it's a great movie, okay? And I'll make sure that the movie reference is at the end of this. It's a great, scary movie. If you want a good movie, you watch this one. It's spelled M-O-C-O-C-H. Moloch. I'm bad at pronouncing things. Radio talk show host that I'm bad at pronouncing things. It's a great movie. I've seen the movie, and it is scary as it is frightening. It really is. Do I personally know anyone who worships this deity in the, I guess they mean in the entertainment business? The words no. I have seen, come on, drink coffee, folks, or whatever you got. I have seen some pretty ratchet shit in the entertainment business, but I don't think I've ever seen that. I've seen people worship deities. I've seen people sell their soul to the devil or whatever you want to say. But I don't think I've ever personally seen that. And, you know, does it help when you do all this kind of stuff? Absolutely not. Well, you know, what makes somebody famous these days are two things. One, more than two things, is creativity, a good manager, and talent, and the ability to, I guess, to learn, you know, because everyone says, oh, I can't act. Anyone can act. Anyone. I don't care if you think you can't act or not. If you were taught your ABCs and your 1, 2, 3s, you could be taught to act. Okay. So it is possible. And the greatest to me acting in the world is a natural actor. Somebody just naturally acting. Why does my nose look purple on the monitor? It looks purple. I don't have a purple nose, folks. If it's looking purple, I don't have a purple nose. Not yet. Anyway, so, no, it doesn't help to sell your soul to the devil or worship some things or go to the Church of Scientology and all this. None of that helps. What helps is some good old-fashioned luck, and really, when you get down to it, a really good manager and developer. And you notice I didn't say agent. I said a really good manager and developer. I think agents, for the most part, man, my voice is leaving me today. Hold on. Ooh, I like that dark cumin. I think agents, for the most part, are scum. They're attorneys, or they're, it's just, and I know a few agent friends of mine, and I say, hey, how you doing there, buddy? So how's the scum life? The difference between a manager and an agent is the manager has a little bit more invested in you. They develop you. They work harder for you. They don't have as many clients out of choice, so they can spend more time working on your career and assisting you. And, of course, you're going to have a good manager that is well connected. I mean, anyone can be an entertainment manager if they want to, but how connected are you? Who do you know? And so we're going to get into that. We're also going to get into the new live action Bambi, and we're going to talk about that right now. In fact, we're going to take a little bit, just a short, a miniature, whatever you want to call it, break, and we'll be right back, and we're going to talk about the live action Bambi and what Disney is doing for all the butthurt people in this world. You're listening to John Wilde, The John Wilde Show.
An accident. Every driver's worst nightmare. But what if you could take it back? Going 65 miles per hour, it takes 365 feet to bring your car to a complete stop. Driving just 5 miles per hour slower, you gain an additional 100 feet of stopping space. So what would you rather save? 30 seconds or a life? Oh my God! Oh my God, it's Hitler!
John Wilde Show. I always have things of legs crawling through. There's always an all-night party with John Wilde. We're having a lot of fun here so far, right? Yay! It's just been a lot of you talking about this and that and the other thing. Well, you know, I do want you to make your comments, because your comments are going to reflect on the next show. We're going to talk about your comments on the next show. So feel free to comment, because in a way that's like talking. Relatively soon, we will be live. We are going to have a live show, and we will be live. So there you go. Okay. Thank you. All right. Dino's let me know a few things. All right. So we're going to try this next, and then we're going to talk about Bambi. It's a whole new different kind of soda from Coca-Cola. Let me get a close-up of that. Okay, is that there you go. So we're going to try this whole new flavor of soda. Coca-Cola's come out with all these new flavors. And, we're going to try this one right here, okay? Have you ever tried this one? Have you seen it? Well, we're going to try it. It's a whole new flavor of Coca-Cola. So let's see what we got here. Oh, my God. Here we go. I can't even. You know what it tastes like? You know what this tastes like? Here's the name of it again. I refuse to say the name because they're not paying me. It tastes like Pepsi. It tastes like Pepsi in a Coca-Cola bottle. And I'm a Pepsi fan more than I'm a Coke fan. You know what it actually really tastes like? Actually, now I taste it again. For those who are old enough, do you remember the original Coca-Cola? Before they had the new Coke, and then they changed it back, and then they had Coke with corn syrup, and it was never the same again. Then they tried to come out with Coke Throwback by putting the sugar in there, but it was still never the same again. It was never that original Coca-Cola that you grew up with. This tastes like that. The original Coca-Cola, because the original Coca-Cola was really kind of sweet. Then they went kind of the bland, and Pepsi went the sweet way. And there you go. Speaking of sweets, you always know when it's officially Christmas. Now, I was in the store the other day, and I saw all the Christmas decorations up. Okay, and I guess it's been a while. I don't care how many decorations you put up. I don't care how many Christmas decorations you put up. I don't care if you got the Christmas song singing and Mariah Carey's fat ass out there. This, when you see this in the store, this is the official start of the holiday seasons. Folks, can I hear an amen? Type amen right now. Amen, right there. Yes. I got this box the other day, and there's one damn tree left. Oh, come on. You remember these things? One damn... Oh, there's two trees left, actually. How did that happen? There should only be one. Yes. And I will probably enjoy this a little bit later. It is the official holiday season when the Little Debbie Christmas cakes are in the stores. And speaking of Little Debbie, let's talk about Little Bambi. And no, not the video that I was watching the other night. This is Disney. And I'm surprised they weren't with the video that I was watching the other night. Live-action Bambi is going to start coming out. Boy, I tell you, my terminology today. And with this live-action, they're going to change it up a little bit. And I'm sure there's going to be... I refuse to say some of the things that I think is going to be happening in this movie because that I'm going to be pegged to some kind of a racist or some kind of a sexist or some kind of a this or some kind of a that. And, you know, it's just it's absolutely untrue. You know, when I date women, I'm an equal opportunity dater. I don't care if you're red and yellow, black and white. You could be zebra. You could be plaid. I'll date you. Yeah, I'll give you the John Wilde treatment. But anyway, during this movie, how did I get off on that? I'm about to have something thrown at me. They're not going to let Bambi's mother die. Because Disney is concerned that... I got to do this the right way. I can make my voices. I used to make a living doing voices, but it would be so much funnier if I did it this way. Let's see. Yes, I know. It would be so much funnier.
If I did it this... We're not going to let Bambi's mother die because all of the people will be so butthurt. They'll cry and poor little Bambi's mother gets burned in the forest and goes away and dies and everyone's sad and all the little children are gathering around and all that bullshit. Exactly.
So basically, because Disney doesn't want to hurt people's feelings, they're going to let Bambi's mother live this time. Folks, when we start teaching our kids at a young age that nothing bad happens, lots of bad is going to happen to them because they're not prepared. They need to know that this world is great, but this world also has a lot of evils in it. And bad things happen. Bad things happen to good people. Mothers and daughters, sisters, brothers, dads, uncles, aunts, grandparents die. There's one thing guaranteed about your life right now, that you are going to die. And what you got to do is make the most of those days while you're living them, while you're breathing them. That you teach your children that. I taught my kids from a very young age, you know what, kids? You will die. We're all going to die. I'm going to die. Your mother's going to die. We're all going to die. Your mother and I are also going to get divorced. Anyway, so they knew. And I that's when I taught them that you got to live every single second of your life to the fullest because you never know when your time is up. It could be at any time. So just live. And don't think about it. And when we show these kids, and I think this is what Disney originally had planned, because I think even Dumbo's mother dies or gets whatever. And its reality is this happens. It's a bummer. It's one of the shit things in life. But you pull yourself up by the bootstrings, you get out there, you find good friends as in Thumper or whatever, and you go forward in the memory of your mother. But to sit there and say, oh, we're not going to have Bambi's mother die because we don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. Oh, my God. That's the problem. That's the problem with this new generation. I would say the last two generations, we're also butthurt about everything. Everything offends us. Everything. You know, I could say, wow, that chair is yellow, and I'll have five people explain to me how calling that chair yellow offends them. It's ridiculous. So I'm going to give, if Disney actually did this, excuse me, don't listen to that. If Disney actually did this, they get an F from me. It is another reason for me to really not like Disney, because I really don't. I'm a Universal guy because I worked for Universal for years. I was the entertainment coordinator. I was a director. I was a producer for the park and a lot of film projects that they had as well. And so I'm a big Universal fan. And Disney does this. So what do you think? I just think we need to stop being concerned about hurting people's feelings and give them a little dose of reality. And it's kind of funny, too, because some of these really young kids, you've got, I think, overly sheltered children. And then you got children today that nothing ever seems to bother them. And all the young talent that I work with are very smart. You like to say usually they're smarter than most adults. And they witness things and they see things. And they'll sit there and watch Disney and all that, then turn around and watch Final Destination and laugh at both of them. So it all depends, I guess, on who you're dealing with. But Disney needs to stop this crap about changing things up and keeping things the way it is. You know, changing the skin color of some of the iconic characters, just to be able to fit in. You know, I know a few people of a different race that were offended, actually, saying, we don't need this. Why don't you come up with a new character that's Black, Hispanic, or Asian or something? Why redo the old characters that were obviously not? So what we need to do is we need to just stop being so butthurt. And this is definitely not a show to watch if you get butthurt easily, believe me. And just relax. And I think a live-action Bambi would be pretty cool. I really dug what they did with The Lion King. I was in awe over that movie. It was fantastic when they did the live-action. I like both of them because both of them resonate in different ways, but they did a great job and they stuck with the storyline for the most part. Well, that's what they need to do when they're changing these iconic movies into live action movies. They need to stay with the storyline exactly how it happened and try not to be the world's feel good, don't cry for me, Argentina people. You know, just show us what you got and we will handle it our ways. And it, you know what? This gives an opportunity for parents to be parents to sit down and talk to your kids after the movie and say, let me tell you, it happens. Okay, Bambi's mother died. It happens. It happens to hundreds and hundreds of kids every single day. They lose one or two of their parents. So how do we deal with this? You think Bambi dealt with it? It's an actual teaching tool. You know, I think these people are popping out kids left and right and not really giving a damn, not teaching them, not showing them, not guiding them. And I do see that. I do see it all the time. It's disgusting to me. If you're going to be a parent, you're a parent. And you need to make sure that you guide your children so they don't end up warped when they get older, because that's exactly what's going to happen. So we're going to continue on here, and we're going to be talking about the entertainment business. Now, of course, you can comment below, please, on anything that I say. You can tell me that I have no idea what I'm freaking talking about and that I'm an idiot, or you can agree with me, or you can put your own opinion in. They're all going to be read, and I might end up bringing them up on the next show, so make sure you do that. And you can see this show on all different things. We're still building this. This is a build in progress. It's still a little wonky. It's still a little bit simple. Right now, we are building a brand new studio, and we're going to be in that. It's going to be really fantastic. And so for right now, we're just winging it. We're just having some fun, and we're just talking. And it's going to get tighter. It's going to get better. Come on now. It's been a long time. You see, I'm kind of running the technical part of the show, not really the technical part, but the creative end of it, where Dino runs the technical. She records it, she uploads it, she edits it, and I come up with the creative part. So together we're going to be making this show a little bit different, and we're going to be spotlighting some things. We're going to be spotlighting some entertainers, because the entertainment business is my business. We're going to talk about that in a second. And I would really love to spotlight unknown talent, even if I don't sign them, even if they're not signed by me. I don't care if they're signed by me or not. If I like them, we'll have them in. We'll talk to them. We'll discover who they are. We're talking about actors, models, musicians, magic show people, and everything. Yeah, we're going to be expanding a lot of that. Of course, we're going to have a critics corner. And we're even going to have a cigar lounge corner. We're going to have the show will be expanding. So right now we're just talking, you and me, mano y mano. That's right. We're going to talk about we're going to talk about the entertainment business. We're going to talk about life, booze, and boobs. Congratulations. No booze today, though. I've got a brand new Coca-Cola in one hand. Oh man, I'm going to be flying. And sorry about the bouncing of everything. And a dark Cuban roast coffee in the other. I'm going to be flying tonight without a wing. Okay, so we're going to talk the entertainment business here. Oh yeah. We're going to get some realities. We're going to bust some myths. I'm going to tell you some things that you probably never even realized. And I tell you, if you know anyone who is trying to be an actress or a model at this point, or want to be or think they are, you might want to call them to your screen to watch this and to learn. Because I'm going to have a real frank talk with a lot of you. First, how am I qualified to even say any of this? I'm not going to give you my age, but I'm not young and I'm not super old. I'm right in the happy middle, but it doesn't matter. You know, I'm a weird guy. I like women so much. I actually rate my age on the age barriers that I would date a woman. I would date a woman who is 25 years old to 60. I'm wide range, baby. And I've met some women that were wide range. Yeah, I really should get my sound effects together. And I met some women that were wide range. Thank you. Thank you. Also, stop hitting the wrong buttons. Ding, ding. Yeah, exactly. That wasn't me. That was Dino. Stop that. Anyway. Thank you. All right. So, I started in the entertainment business when I was 10 years old. I started as a young actor, and I used to do bit roles, and I did commercials, and I did a few movies. And with me, it was kind of a hobby because my father was a professional extra. He was in several things, and I really dug that, so I started doing it. And excuse me, that Coca-Cola is something else. So what I did is, like most young people on a set, they will try their hardest to talk to the stars or to sit around the craft table or fool around and all that. What I did is I hunted down producers and directors and the filming people, and I started to learn at a young age about the real entertainment business. I hooked up with some agents and some managers just to learn from them, not really to be represented or anything by them, but just to learn from them. And that's what I started doing through my whole life. And when I was a teenager, I got into the music business and I started learning the music business from some of the biggest people in the music business. I was able to hook up with them because I didn't act starstruck when I met celebrities and producers and directors when I was younger. I acted like I would really like to learn from you. And they really dug that kind of a thing. They, instead of saying, oh, can I have your autograph? And oh, this and that. And that. Oh, I can't believe I'm meeting you. Oh. I would sit down at a young age and try to talk as smart as I can to these guys so I can learn. And that's exactly what I started doing. And I've learned from the biggest and the best. I mean, if you can think of the biggest directors, biggest producers, and biggest stars, even of today, yes, I've probably talked to them and I've learned from them and I've gotten advice throughout the years. So in the music business, I was literally having conversations with Bernard Edwards and some of these bigger producers. And learning all about that, I hooked up with Duran Duran, and boy, did they teach me a lot of things, and so did their managers. And I learned a lot. And then I got more into the entertainment business again, doing voice work for cartoons and video games and all that. And that is where I started meeting some big stars and meeting some big producers, really kind of through that. And I started learning and learning and learning. Some of the biggest agents, which were actual agents in those days, and I started to learn from them and managers, and I learned the difference. I was just learning everything that I could absorb. The real world, getting sunk into the real world of the entertainment business and understanding what it takes. Because I didn't want to play in the minor leagues. What is the minor leagues? Minor leagues are independent films, small films, commercials, national commercials. That's small leagues, folks. Okay, you're not in the major leagues doing national commercials. Magazine covers, you know, and all this. You know, if you're on the cover of Vogue, I'm impressed. You're no longer in the minor leagues. But if you're on the cover of just some fashion magazine out of New York or Miami, you're in the minor leagues. Sorry. You know, you could have 100 credits to your name on doing things like that or acting. You're still in the minor leagues unless you're doing a movie that's released nationally in theaters and is Oscar worthy or could be a candidate for that. Then you're in the major leagues. When you're pulling $10,000 minimum for a small role up to $30,000, $40,000, now you're in the big leagues. That's big leagues. Anything else than that, you're in the minor leagues. Nothing wrong with the minor leagues, but you know, don't have delusions of grandeur. So that's where I started learning, and it was just years and years and years of experience. That's I just sucked myself into it full time. I worked for Lou Pearlman. I helped put together Transcontinental Records, and that was a learning experience, putting together bands like NSYNC, Backstreet Boys, 98 Degrees, and on and on. That putting these guys together, that was a learning experience because Lou Pearlman didn't know crap. That's why he came to me. But I knew people, and I knew the producers and some people that he knew. And I kept learning and learning and knowledge and knowledge. And then I worked for two of the biggest agencies in the world. And I learned doing that as well. I learned the right things and the wrong things. And what I started learning also was there's a big difference between what you, the general public, sees in the entertainment business and what we see behind the scenes. If you actually think that you have a reality of what they really go through and what it really takes and what they really do to make it and all this, you got another thing coming, because all of the Google videos, all of the YouTube videos, all the self-help videos and all that are full of shit. Every single one of them. It's bullshit. Okay. There is a whole big different world out there, and it's dog eat dog. It's nasty. It's dirty. And unless you're willing to sink yourself into that, you will never get into the major leagues as an actress or a model or an actor or a model. Actually, they don't call them actresses anymore. It's just actors now. It's just the way it is. So when you refer to an actor, that could be a male or a female. Same thing, model could be male or a female. So basically, what really gets me is the advent of, and this was the big argument the other day, these sites that you can get on and list for roles in independent films, commercials, and things like that. I think there's a one called The Green Room. There's another one called Backstage. Then there's the horrible group pages that you see on Facebook. Those are a joke. And the thing about it is, a lot of these talents take that seriously, thinking that this is a serious way to go, and they don't want a manager. They think they're going to manage themselves. They're going to book everything themselves, and that's wonderful, but you're never going to get out of the minor leagues doing that. No matter what you think, you're not. Plain and simple. Period. You're not going to. It's not going to work. Sorry. No. There has never been in the history of film any major actor who has made it without representation. no matter what you think they say, no matter what their spin doctor wants to teach you, it's never happened and it never will. It's a good old boy network that deals with manager. You got to know what you're doing. You have to be an agent or a manager, and a real agent, not a fake one. I see those all the time on these things. Photographers that think that they can book people. Really? No, you will not make it without proper representation. And to get that proper representation is very hard. You have a better chance of winning the lottery twice and then getting hit by lightning twice on the way back to cash in your third lottery winning than have somebody of my stature or anyone else accept you as talent and make you what you need to be. It is a very rare event. Now, can it happen? Absolutely. How can it happen? Well, that's totally up to you. You got to put in the fight. You got to do what you got to do to make it. It's a dirty, nasty climb to the top, but once you get up to the top of the mountain, it's absolutely beautiful. And there's a lot of haters about the entertainment business. I got a friend on Facebook. His name is Martin. Marty. He knows who he is from Chicago area. He hates the entertainment business. He hates on it so much. He thinks he knows everything about it because of his comments, but he doesn't know shit. And I love you, Marty, but you don't know shit, dude. You may know about your business, and he is a professional. He is an absolute genius of what he does for a living, which I won't really say because I don't have his permission. But he's a genius of what he does, but he's not a genius in the entertainment business because that's nowhere near what he does. And he gets it wrong every single time. And even these actresses that I see, and it's so funny too, because I see the same actresses for the last 10 years or actors trying to make it on these Facebook posts and all this, trying. And they never make it to the big leagues. They never make it past a certain point because they're representing themselves. It's I hearken it to this. If you have a heart attack, are you going to perform open heart surgery on yourself? No, you want a professional who knows what they're doing and is connected and has the wherewithal. I can pick up if someone comes to me, it's not this easy, believe me, folks. But somebody comes up to me and says, I want to be famous. I could pick it up, make two phone calls, and have you in a major motion picture when the strike is over. Not starring, but just about to where you'll be recognized and you'll get a good paycheck. And who knows what might go from there. And just because that you work hard on independent films and some small little stuff and maybe a show or two, some kind of failed sitcom or whatever, and you're able to get a SAG card, still doesn't mean anything. All right, there are thousands and thousands and thousands of people with SAG cards. Doesn't mean a damn thing. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of people with SAG cards that aren't doing anything. And won't, because they don't have the proper representation. And if you really think you're going to do it on your own, forget about it. And another thing that really drives and grinds my gears are these agencies that claim to be agencies, and all they are is that some of them actually ask for money. I'm amazed if a management company or an agency asks you for a penny, they are a fraud. They are a scam. That is not how it's done in the real world, folks. You don't have to pay for representation. You just have to convince a manager to represent you. You have to impress them like you've never impressed anybody in your life. Becoming an actual high-end actor is the hardest thing to. It is easier to become the president of the United States. It is easier to become a congressman. It is easier to become an astronaut. Believe me, there are people who do independent films and small films their entire life and never make it because they refuse to do what they have to do to push the envelope to get up there. Now, I'm not saying sell your soul to the devil, and I'm not saying, you know, worship Moloch and all this other kind of stuff. No, I'm not saying anything like that. I'm just saying you got to put yourself above the rest, because no matter how good looking you are and how talented you are, there's 1,000 people who just look just like you and is just as talented as you are that want the same thing you do. What are you going to do to put yourself in front of all of that? And some people say, well, some people do some things like the casting couch and all that, does that exist? I get that question every single day. Does the casting couch actually exist? Yes and no. The casting couch doesn't really truly exist very much where it comes to casting, where it comes to going into a show. But at the management level, to get to the people who can make you famous, does it exist? Absolutely it does. It exists in every major corporation or business. Are you kidding me? Why do you think nurses like to date doctors when they want to become doctors? Really? Come on, reality time here, folks. I don't want to sit here and play in the pudding, okay? I want to give you a dose of reality, okay? Just because you don't want to believe it doesn't mean it's not real. It is real, and it does happen. Now, there's a big difference between the Harvey Weinsteins of the world and the casting couch. Harvey Weinstein was a piece of shit. He was drugging and forcing women into doing things. You don't have to drug and force at all. The people that I know that I've seen that work the casting couch, they say, hey, you can if you want to. It's totally up to you. You got to make your own decisions. There's no force. There's no, well, you're not going to make it unless you do this. There's no coercion. They just do it because they know that it's going to help them. So they do it. It happens, folks. I'm sorry. I personally don't subscribe to that. But I'm not going to sit here and tell you it doesn't happen. It does happen. And if a celebrity forces them or drugs you or threatens them or coerces them, then that piece of shit needs to go to prison. But if it's a two consenting adults agreeing to a situation, then let them do whatever they want to do. Hey, it's unfair. I'm not doing that. You know, I hear actresses, I'm not doing that. And it's unfair for me because I refuse to do that. But these other actresses are doing it and they're getting all the work ahead of me and this and that and the other thing. Well, okay. Yeah, that sucks. Welcome to reality. Like I said earlier with the whole Bambi thing, there's fantasy and then there's reality. Welcome to the world of reality. Welcome to the business. It sucks. Sometimes if you refuse to do things like that or payola, which is illegal, but there's a way to do it that's not illegal. You can work the network and the good old people just keep trying and trying and trying and then show them that you've got something that is unique, that is special, and you're the one that needs to be picked, and then you can get picked. And it's so funny because I hear talent all the time say, well, these famous movie stars that are out there said they never had to do that. They didn't do that. It's not how they made it. Really? I can say that I climbed to the Empire State Building, jumped off into a glass of water, and survived. I can say anything. They can say anything. Of course, they're going to try to protect their reputation and try to look like them. But believe me, I know what a lot of major stars have done to get to where they're at. And it's not pretty. And I'm not going to sit here and name names. I'm not going to spill it. Let them have their little stories that their spin doctors came up with to make them look good. But really, no. I know what they did. And it's not always like sexual or the casting couch, but it's a dog-eat-dog business. It really, really is. And if you have a lot of money, some of these actresses and actors that have done a lot and been able to save up and they have a lot of money, sometimes they spend tons of money to get to the right people. And it's not buying them off, but you know, a lot of gifts, a lot of travel, a lot of wine and roses and caviar and trips on the boat. It's like every politician out there wooing their people for money or for prestige or whatever. It's the same thing in the entertainment business. And is it worth it? Absolutely. It's the greatest job in the world. I mean, I want you to think about this. You get paid buttloads, truckloads, unbelievable money to be creative and play all day long. Now, it's not as easy as I say. Sometimes it gets very frustrating, and you got to be used to redundancy, definitely, and this and that, but it is the greatest job in the world. It really is, especially if you have a creative soul. And if you want to entertain and you want to be out there, and a lot of talent, and I'm not going to sit here and judge them because of it, have what they call like kind of like a worship envy. They like the fact that millions of people, or when you're starting out, maybe even thousands or hundreds of thousands of people are fans of theirs and want to meet them, and you know, will do anything to have a signature and a photo with them and go watch their stuff and respond, and they have this fan complex, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's great to be appreciated for what you do. So you're making tons of money. You can do anything in this world you want to do. You travel all over the world to get paid for it and get treated like a VIP everywhere you go. And then you have tons of fans that just adore you. It is really worth the climb. It's worth it. It's worth whatever you got to do to get into the business and work hard. So would I recommend, hey, you know what? You're a young talent. Just find a casting couch. No, I would not recommend you do that at all. Absolutely not. Don't do that to yourself. But be prepared to work your ass off and do everything you can to impress the right people. And never think that you failed. Never think that you're untalented or you can't learn. Never think you're too old, you're too fat, you're too this, you're too that. It's when I look for talent, I look for, even though it's kind of hard to believe because some people have seen on social media, but I look for all shapes and sizes, all ages, all walks of life, because when you watch television and movies, a lot of the times you see the regular looking everyday people now. It's becoming a popular thing. And if you have freckles, you just tripled your pay, by the way. That's huge. It's been huge for the last 4 or 5 years, and it's still huge. I get requests in my office every single day for talent, and usually the first 4 or 5 requests is they must have freckles. Freckles is a huge thing. Where in the past, freckles was kind of you wanted to hide that with a ton of makeup. Now, if you have freckles and you hide it with makeup, you're an idiot. That is why I see models all the time put themselves out there on these websites and these group pages, and they cover up their freckles, and they pose the wrong way, or they do, even on Model Mayhem, some of these poses that they put on there are stupid. Somebody in a high level, they're not going to want to see these fancy smancy professional photos of you. They're not going to want to see that. They're not going to want to see you posing in a meadow with leaves falling around you, or in the middle of New York City with fog around you and all that. They want to see you standing there in front of the camera with very, very little makeup on, no filter, looking natural, looking right at the camera, snap. That's what the people at my level want to see. They don't want to see these fantasy photos of you. They want to see reality. They want to see what you look like, face, different clothes, everything from dress up all the way to sexy. They want to see side views, back views, front views. That's what they want to see. And if they want to see anything else, they'll contact you and ask. They just want to see you in your natural state, doing natural things. Don't get fancy and spend a lot of money. Sorry, photographers, I love you to death, but come on now. Reality is, when I see these things cross and they have nothing but these fancy schmancy retouch photos with these great backgrounds and all this fog and effects and lighting and all that, I just boop, discard it. Next. Because to me, that's not professional. You're trying to make some kind of fantasy world for yourself. That's not reality. So there's a lot of reality right there. And the bottom line is, will you make it in the big leagues without representation? No. Will you make it in the big leagues representing yourself and just doing nothing but these small independent things and commercials and some videos and some photographers and then the things you see on these group pages and these websites? No. So smarten up. And if your talent represented by me or not, and you always want advice, get a hold of me. I give advice to people who are not signed with me or not my talent every single day, because I believe in this business and I love this business. And I want to see people going the right way. And if I personally don't have the time to consult with you, I will put you with people that I know and trust that can consult with you and help you out. No charge. They're here to help because they love the business too. They can't get too into it with you, but they can give quick advice. Anyway, this is John Wilde. We're going to take a break right now. We're going to come back. You're watching John Wilde Show. Don't go nowhere.
popsicle?
No, honey, you'll spoil your...
Hey, parents! Tired of those out-of-control kids? Throwing embarrassing tantrums wherever they go! At the grocery store, on the playground, even at the dinner table! You've had it with parenting, but wait, there is a solution. Introducing Naptime, the latest most effective tool for child tantrum prevention. It's simple. Just douse a rag with our patented Sleepy Time formula, place it over your child's cry hole, press and hold gently for 8 to 12 seconds, and presto, no more tantrum.
I was beginning to think adoption was the only way out. Then a friend of mine introduced me to Naptime. It's never been so quiet around here.
The secret lies in Naptime's revolutionary fast asleep formula. Developed by military-trained scientist doctors from NASA, Naptime's powerful molecules rush to the child's brain on contact, gently inducing instant tranquility.
This is chloroform.
Already put those wallet-draining crap factories out on the street? That's okay! Naptime works in any situation. On the golf course. An awkward blind date.
I had a really good time tonight.
It even works on pets.
After we had our first child here, we regretted it almost immediately.
We didn't know that she'd cry so much.
Talk about defective. But thanks to Naptime, our little Samantha here hasn't made a noise in weeks. I keep her in a shoebox.
Call now and we'll send you your very own 24-ounce bottle of Naptime Solution for only 23 easy payments of $1.99. But wait, there's more! Act quickly and you'll also receive the all-new Dream Sack, absolutely free! It's compact and portable for those on-the-go tantrums. Just cover it, tighten it, and forget about it. It's that simple.
We can't breathe good.
So if this looks familiar...
I feel pregnant.
Then don't wait! Order today and join the millions of Americans who just can't stop saying...
Thanks, Naptime.
Thanks, Naptime!
Thanks, Naptime.
Naptime! When they just won't shut up. Naptime is not legal in the following states.
Gone Wild. Gone Wild Show. Giving you a taste of reality, people. And everything that I know. Love Slade. This is Slade. This is the original, like, rockers who's if it wasn't for Slade, there wouldn't be AC/DC and so forth. So there you go. Slade came out the same time like Kiss came out, so they're all, like, in the same category there for a while. You know the AC/DC song, Come On, come, We're All Crazy Now, and then the AC/DC song, Mental Health? Well, this band is the one that originally did those songs. Slade. Alright, you're listening to the John Wild Show, and we are still continuing on and on and on, and we're babbling about a lot of this and a lot of that and a lot of nothing. So thank you for tuning in, and the curse of the John Wild, there you go. The crust of the show was reality in the entertainment business, and I hope I gave some. Also, V3000, I guess, I'm going to say the name of it, is a soda we're trying for the first time. And so this is what I'm going to do on this soda. From a scale from 1 to 10, 1 being the worst thing that I've ever put in my mouth, 10 being the greatest thing I've ever put in my mouth, I'm going to rate this one. Actually, it's really good. It reminds me a lot of the old Coke and it's the V3000 flavor. It reminds me of the old Coke and kind of a Pepsi kind of combined, I guess. So I really do like it. I'm going to give it an 8. So there you go. Try it. Would I recommend you try it? Absolutely. Try it. If you try it, let me know what you think in the comments. If you've tried it, let me know what you think in the comments. And what is your favorite Christmas treat coming out? Mine's a Little Debbie Christmas things. And you know, after the show, I'm going to devour this. It's going to look like an orgy of Christmas cake being swallowed by the John Wild. And I might actually do a dolphin where I swallow the whole thing just whole. That would be a video. I know that would be a video. Thank you for sharing that. Anyway, so we're going to do a little housekeeping, and then we're going to call it a show. Now, anything that I comment about, if you're interested in getting a hold of me and talking to me, you can always comment here. Absolutely anytime you want to. We're going to have an email, a special email address. She's working on that now. And if it's done up before the end of the show, it'll be in the credits. But we're going to have that, and that'd be another way you can get a hold of me and ask me anything that you want to ask me. If you're a talent out there and you really want to either be a talent or you are a talent and you want to change your life and you want to really kind of, I can't guarantee anything. It's very rare I sign people, but I'm always looking for that special diamond in the rough. And again, looks, age, race, sizes, doesn't matter. What matters is if you have talent and you have the passion to make it in this world. You have to have the will and you have to have the want. More than any other business in this world, you really got to have that passion for your work. If I feel and I see that passion and that willingness, you know, things can happen. No promises, but for talent only, it's J Wild, first initial J, but no period, just one word, J Wild, like me, management@gmail.com. And please, if you send photos that are retouched, filtered, and all the fancy shit, it'll be rejected immediately. Take that camera, turn it to you, snapshots. No makeup or very little makeup, no freaking filters. Be real. We don't have time for that. We're going to try to start putting out a daily show, at least an every other day show. So we're going to work on that really hard. As long as I can get my producer and me in the same place, we can start pounding out these shows and talking about what's going on. And if there's a subject that you want me to talk about, comment below. I would love to talk about what you want to talk about. And that's kind of a way of doing these things until we can have live call-in. And so there you go. Starting next week, we're going to have contests where you can actually try to win prizes with John Wild. And if you want to mail me anything, you have to leave a comment or send a private message, and my people will read it, and they will tell you how to mail me cards, letters. I have a blank wall here. I'd love to fill up with you. If you're an artist or if you have artwork or something you'd like me to put up there, I would love to start filling my wall of my fans and my listeners stuff. So when you send me stuff, I'll put it up there. I love coffee mugs. Just letting you know. So I'm all for that. Please start, because I would really love that. And I do want to appreciate the person who sent me that Halloween card. You know who you are. Thank you for the donation. It's really sweet. Y'all don't have to do that, but thank you very much. It's going to go right back into the show. And pretty soon we're going to have give backs. So when you donate money like that, because we're hopefully have sponsors here pretty soon, all that money will go for our charitable work and our give backs. And the first thing that's going to start here within a matter of weeks is our Toys for Tots program. So absolutely, no matter where you're at in this world, you can help us out with Toys for Tots. It doesn't matter if you're in Alabama or if you live in Singapore. If you want to help out a child in Central Florida, we'd appreciate that, because that's where we're at, and that's where we're going to be gathering the toys for. That's going to start here really soon, and other things, okay? So this is John Wilde. It has been wonderful for you to join me for this time. And the next show's coming up either tomorrow or the next day. We're going to start to get this continuity going. We're going to start putting this this train more on the track for you. And again, my shows aren't scripted. I just want to sit here and have a drink and talk to you like normal. You don't show up at a coffee shop with your friends with a script and say, so how have you been doing today? I have been doing fine. Today I walked over and I kicked a puppy because I just wanted to do that. You know, we talk like we're talking here. Okay. That's all there is to it. And also, I will say that even though I've kept it kind of cool on the show, remember, my show is rated PG-13 because we do talk about women and men and things. In fact, next show, we're going to be talking about favorite sexual positions. So, and toys. But yeah, so there's a preview. So remember, I love the kids, okay, but sometimes they may not want to listen to the John Wilde show if they're under a certain age. Either that, or you're going to have a whole different conversation with them at night once they listen to the show. Anyway, so, hey, we have a lot of fun. We're human. And never forget, John Wilde loves you. You take care. Oh, and one other thing I almost forgot. Thank you, Dino. She put it up here on the thing. If you're a musician, we're looking for some original music to spotlight here on the show. So send a DM, private message about your band and a little sample. And if you're chosen, you'll be asked to email it and we will talk about it and play your music. I always love to support local music. So spread the word about that too. John Wilde loves you. Take care. We'll see you on the next one. Flexing.